everyone, Draco Magnus here for another episode of Let's Play Pokémon Colosseum. In the last episode, we went further into the Shadow Pokémon Lab, and I made crap tons of errors trying to catch certain Shadow Pokémon. In this episode, we're going to continue on further into the Shadow Pokémon Lab, hopefully not make as many errors with catching Shadow Pokémon, and get some more DNA samples for whatever reason, and maybe find out what the use of the DNA samples is. The first battle. What in the name of... How did you avoid the eyes of our security staff? You mean those cipher peons that I've been beating the living tar out of? Very easily. I mean, their scare tactic jumping from the ceiling isn't really effective. I mean, it's kind of surprising the first time, but after the second time, you're just like, oh, hey, another one. Double electrode across the sky. Oh crap, I forgot to change my party from what it was last time. Who did I have? Ah, Rap and Dandy. Not that big a deal then. I mean, I can use Dig to get rid of one electrode. And I can possibly put the other to sleep. Okay, so that one doesn't know self-destruct, otherwise they'd more than likely use it. So neither of them know self-destruct? Oh, well, this battle's gonna be fairly simple. Why are they picking so harshly on Dandy? Boo! Come on, Dandy, you can do better than that. I believe in you, Dandy! Unless you get killed here, then I no longer believe in you. Oh, okay. That's why they were doing it, because they wanted to do more damage to Dandy for whatever reason. Seriously, I don't understand that. It's not strong against either of you. Oh, you bastards can burn in hell. Stupid friggin' balls. Electro... Dig. Actually, at that point, it's not really gonna matter, so Giga Drain. Oh, you bastard! Meh. Ah, that is annoying. Electrode. Serves you right. And all he did was knock out one Pokemon. Do you feel proud of yourself? Dubbick? You didn't duck from security. You walked all over them. Damn straight. Do whatever you want. It's too late now. We're finished with our research. What you're doing is futile. We'll see about that. First, I'm healing up. Because he's an ass. Alright, now I guess I'll use some of those super potions I got. Oh, I love super potions. And any potion, really. Potions are fun. DNA sample. Huh, there is a, like, robotic casket over there. That's odd. Is there a DNA sample over here? Something shiny? No. Something shiny? No. Pidgey, what were you doing over there by the scientist? Were you having a palaver? Talking, hey, what's up, scientist man? Oh, not much. Just being a scientist kind of got my ass handed to me by your boyfriend. Even though I am not her boyfriend. Moving on. Alright, these are elevators, as you can all figure out. Let's see. Back of this room. Well, back of this room. Blah, 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 blah. Also, blah, blah, blah. Okay, they want us to take the first elevator after collecting the DNA sample that's here and battling the Shadow Pokemon Trainer, who has nothing but normal-type Pokemon, so we're bringing Bruce Lee out. Oh, hi, Thar. Sweeties, you caused enough mischief already. But every other scientist says there's no point in us being here, so why bother, Tanny? Why not just let us roam around the lab, do whatever the hell we want, because you clearly cleared out. Anyway, cutting this here to put the bio sheet in.
And the fifth shadow Pokemon of the Shadow Pokemon Labs is Gronbull. Gronbull is a normal type, pure normal type, so he has the same weaknesses and strength as all of them. Comparatively, he is stronger than Aipom, but not as strong as Stantler, so if he caught Stantler, he isn't really worth the catch. His stats are mid HP, mid speed, almost said special attack, but that's not right. Its attack is very high, its defense is mid, its special attack is almost mid, and its special defense is mid. Starts out with the moves Shadow Rush, Scary Face, Roar, and Strength. So, yeah, almost forgot. Its ability is Intimidate, so if you throw it out into battle for the first time, or you switch it into battle, the opponent's attack stat gets lowered. So, it's essentially a weaker Stantler that looks like a Bulldog. Like I said, if you got Stantler, I really couldn't recommend Gronbull, but if you missed out on Stantler and you didn't, save somewhere and reset the game to try and catch Stantler, I guess you'd want to catch Gronbull. But, whatever.
Okay, let's get this party started with a high jump kick into Lilloon's face and putting Gronbull to sleep. After that, I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to handle the Gronbull. I mean, I can't exactly use my Bruce Lee's fighting attack. Maybe I'll just use Confusion on it. Or I'll just use Giga Drain from Dandy over and over again until it's low enough. But we'll see how everything works out. No! Ah, Vigoroth! Good to see ya, Jumpy. Here, have a high jump kick to the face while I slowly drain the Gronbull's health. Although, who knows? Like I said, it might go faster than I anticipate. No, it's gonna go slow as hell. Good to know. Well, he's got some health out of the deal. Wah! Why, you know, go away, Vigoroth. Oh, jeez. I'm gonna use Confusion on Gronbull to see if that does anything to help me. And I'm gonna drain Vigoroth of his health, because he won't be needing it anymore. Take that, Jumpy. Vigor, I should say. Vigoroth. Please don't be too successful. Oh. Well, then I guess I'm just gonna Please don't attack Jumpluff. I said don't attack Jumpluff! What, do your ears not work? They're big enough! That's right, I'm insulting the Pokemon to demoralize it. Why not? I mean, its moves can't affect me, and she has Psybeam, so... You know what? Let's see what does more. Confusion or Psybeam, because I'm not exactly sure. 50. Okay, so I'll use Psybeam, and I'll spend some time healing on the sidelines to bring Jumpluff back, to put him back to sleep, or her back to sleep. I don't remember what gender the Gronbull was. Anywho! Alright, one more should make it low enough. Oh no, not a scary face. The horror. The horror of having my speed lowered slightly. Whatever shall I do? I am at a loss. I might be screwed, guys. I mean, my speed was lowered a great deal, and Medicham was so crucial to victory in this fight right now. My Sarcasometer is off the charts. Well, that was serious, so it just went back down to normal. Is that really how you're going to spend the rest of your of this battle, Gronble, just lowering speed. No, if that's the case, I'm just going to use my Ultra Ball now. Or, I'm sorry, Ultra Snag Ball. One, two, three, four. Yes! Caught! That was easy. Your mischief is going overboard! Well, that was easy. And now she's vanished like a ghost in the night. Give me the DNA sample. And of course, cutting this here, so I can save, because like I said before, I've learned my lesson. I believe there's a shadow Pokemon coming up next downstairs. Oh, and something else that I'll have to tell you about when we start again. See you guys in a... Oh, and I dropped my controller by accident, sorry. Anyway, see you guys in a few seconds.
Okay, and we're back. The thing I want to show you isn't until a little later, so I'm going to hold off on that. But I've been looking forward to showing you guys this thing since I... Well, since I saw it in the strategy guide, which was, like, when I first got... Oh, God! Right now! Okay. Now, before anything... Wait, really? Now? Did I go in the wrong elevator? I may have gone in the wrong elevator by mistake. Yeah, I'm thinking that is exactly what I did. Whoops.
Then I'm gonna have an early Shadow Pokemon battle. Well, here's the thing I want to show you. I have to cut the video here to show you. It's something I scanned directly out of the book. Just
look. I scanned this straight from the book into my computer. Notice anything that seems a little, I don't know, off? I mean, Electrode is fine. It's an electric Pokemon. Looks fine. Ampharos, also an electric Pokemon, looks fine. Oh, but what is that in the middle? Magneton, you say? You know, I'd like to think I know a reasonable amount about Pokemon, but I don't seem to recall Magneton ever being a giant green flying serpent. I remember a giant green flying serpent. It was called Rayquaza, and I know the pronunciation is Rayquaza, but I think Rayquaza sounds better, so I'm not going to change my way of saying it. But yeah, last time I checked, Magneton was three Magnemites fused together, not giant flying green serpent. And the fact that they got this wrong is just so ridiculously hilarious. That Pokemon isn't even in the game. At all. There's no trainer that has him, at least not in story mode that I'm aware of. You can't catch Rayquaza. He isn't in the game at all, yet apparently the guide thought that Magnetons look like Rayquaza. Whatever. Whatever, I guess. They were like, well, we gotta throw this book together. Let's just put whatever the hell we find in and see if it works. Jeez. Out of all the mistakes in this game, or in this guide, I have to say, this one is my favorite. To prove that strategy guides are crap. That's all.
So yeah, quite a big error, huh? Anyway, let's battle this guy. Kotan. Kotan, are you aware you're misrepresented in the strategy guide as having a Rayquaza? You know what would be funny? If I actually just made a colossal ass of myself, turns out he does have a Rayquaza the whole time. Boy, would my face be red. I forgot to switch him back out. Oh well. But then again, in my defense, I didn't expect this to happen. Go to sleep, Electro, please. It's more than likely it has self-destruct or explosion. Really? Why does an Electrode have Rain Dance? Unless... You know, it might be possible that it actually does power up electrical moves, so I guess I can kind of see it. Jeez, even when it's sleeping, it has that smug smile on its face. Ah! Yeah, let's get rid of Electrode first, and let's try to put Magneton to sleep. Boo! Boo! How dare you attack first. Well, technically I attacked first, but... Nice! Way to take a hit for the team jump block. You know what? I'm curious. If Synthesize works as well in the rain. Probably not. I think it has to be under sunny day where it works better. But still decent amount, I guess. Probably still going to get one hit KO'd by Thunder now. Sorry, Dandy. No, let's send out Static. I mean, he is an electric, but one, he doesn't get as affected by electric-type attacks. And... Brakow! Goodbye, Electrode. No exploding for you. At least not today. Oh hey, your Ampharos is the exact same level as mine. But a different gender, I think, right? Yep, different gender. Hey, maybe my Ampharos and your Ampharos could play sometime. Though my Ampharos only has a bunch of electric moves. Actually, no, I'm going to take this time to hit revive and bring back jump bluff just in case we hit and go into any rocky territory. I mean, I know he doesn't have any rock Pokemon. What I mean is, like, if we run into a person with a shadow Pokemon anytime soon. Oh wow, his Ampharos has a much more powerful electrical move than mine does. I'm paying for it. Your Ampharos isn't nice. There we go. Dandy is all set and ready to go. You know who I'm gonna bring out? Lombay, who also has Dig. So we can do double Dig across the sky. Well, underground, but you get the idea.
Magneton.
How? I didn't want to feel the thunder. Oh, hey, the rain stopped. Dig a hole, dig a hole. No, you can't do jack diddly crap to either of my Pokemon. Meh. By the way, you guys don't know, but every time I go meh, I stick out my tongue and I pull my eye down like they do in the Pokemon anime for some unknown reason. You know, pull your eyelid down while you stick your tongue out. Figured while I was doing a Pokemon game, I'd do that. I'll let you in on that little bit of information. Aw, crud, there's no way I'm gonna let you go. Really? Because everyone else has. Why are you different? Damn it! Wahaha! Now you're stuck. There's no escaping the lab for you. Yet I have enough time to do this. There's no escaping, but you know, if you want to just stand here like a moron and heal your Pokemon, I'm not really going to do anything to stop you outside of laughing at you. Well, let's see. Next person... I think it would be in my best interest to... Should I switch Draco out or Static? That is the question. Well, it depends on what she decides to bring out. Actually, Draco would probably be the best decision. And here I am minding my own business, not paying attention to his stupid alarm. Wonder if I go downstairs if the alarm just stops. Nope. I assume I'd have to go the other way, and I apologize for the annoying... Woo! Noise, but we're we're just going to completely ignore it. Oh, hey, look, we're in the room with the thingamajig. It's a DNA analyzer. Well, then let's give it our DNA samples to use. DNA sample was that of Pseudo Wudo. Keep these in mind when you're putting your DNA sampler in. So we have Pseudo Wudo. Croconaw. What? I can't use my DNA sample that I have, unlike the other one? Oh, duh, because I already used it. And the Mightyena. Well, I'm going to mute that a little bit. Actually, no. Let's just mute the TV.
There, that's better. Now I can hear myself think. Your samples will be different, more than likely. You might get the ones I got, you might not. Because I realized something about why the strategy guide says possibly DNA sample might be in the room. Because every time you play this game, more than likely, they shuffle the locations of the DNA samples and what Pokemon the DNA samples are for. As of right now, I have a Mightyena, Croconaw, and Pseudo Wudo, which I should more than likely remember. But now, we're going to go back to where we saw that scientist, and I'm unfortunately going to turn the sound on in case anything else happens. And now the scientist just magically vanished into thin air, because why not? Because people do that all the time. What's down here? Wait. Where is my map? Map, there you are. Okay, so I am either on basement floor... One? No, yeah, I'm on basement floor one. That's what it says. Ooh. I'm just about to go into, like, the last area, and I didn't get a few treasure chests I could get, I don't think. Because the strategy guy didn't point them out! But I should go do that before... Well, first we're taking care of this alarm, I guess. Oh, hey, there's... Wait, there's a lift down here? Where does that lift go? Oh. This isn't... No, it has to be on the map. Then I have no clue where I am on this map, then. It's like I'm in an area that doesn't exist. Oh! Okay, I see now. I'm a moron. I didn't go back in the friggin' elevator when I should have. Whoopsie! Totally my fault. I apologize. Wasn't paying attention. Okay, now we're on the right floor. And there's the scientist. And a shadow Pokemon battle will be right here. Hi! I heard the alarm, so I came running. Well, that would be the general response to an alarm, Remel. Interesting name you have there. And I'm going to cut this here for a Pokemon bio sheet.
All right, sixth shadow Pokemon of the Shadow Pokemon Labs and fifth RSP, Vibrava. Vibrava is a ground dragon type. Very, very interesting typing, and unfortunately the only dragon type in the game. I love dragon types. Being a dragon type, it is 4 times resistant to ice, or 4 times weak to ice, I should say. I don't know why I said resistance. I know that for a fact is wrong. And it's 2 times weak to dragon type moves. However, since it has the ability Levitate, it's immune to ground type moves, and being a ground type, it's immune to electric type moves. It's half times resistance to poison, rock, and fire type moves. Its stats are kind of weak when you first get it. It has low HP, mid speed, mid attack, mid defense, almost mid special attack, and almost mid special defense. But when it evolves into Flygon at level 45, its HP gets raised to mid level, its speed to high level, its attack to high level, its defense stays at mid level, but its special attack gets to almost high, and its special defense stays at mid. So when it evolves into Flygon, it becomes a decent attacker. Excuse me. I definitely recommend getting it for Flygon. Almost forgot to mention its moveset. It starts out with the move Shadow Rush, Screech, Sand Tomb, and Dragon Breath. So yeah, if you want a dragon Pokemon, I definitely suggest Vibras, since it's the only one in the game. Oh, also, something I want to bring up. As you can clearly tell there, Vibrava is a, dragonfly, and so is Yanma. So why is it that Yanma isn't also a dragon subtype, since it was also a dragonfly? What, just because it doesn't transform into a dragon like the awesome Vibrava? And the awesome Flygon? I still think, even though I hate Yanma, they should have at least given him, dragon subtype. But, whatever. I didn't create the game, I can't
control
that.
Okay, this should be fairly simple. Shadow Ball Kadabra, Sleep Powder Vibra. Go to sleep, Vibrava. You are under my control. Even though you sleep with your eyes wide open, which is kind of creepy. Kadabra, I'm gonna take that spoon from you and hit you with it for the rest of eternity. Like a Gino Sanji. A Gino Saji, I should say. Kadabra! See, I've already started by using my mind to hit you with the spoon. Because I can totally do that. Kecleon, normal type. So punching it in the face with Bruce Lee would probably be the most effective strategy of taking it down. I'm thinking Psybeam on Vibrava, Vibrava, yeah. I'm bringing up Bruce Lee. Although maybe I should have switched, no, because I need Draco to attack it. Oh, actually that worked fantastically. My god, that was beautiful. Now stay asleep. Oh, crap. Why do you have Aerial Ace? You're not even a flying type. What the crap? Can anyone explain that to me? Why a normal type that doesn't have wings has Aerial Ace? Whatever. Catch Vibrava. High jump kick on Kecleon's face. Come on. I need to catch you, Vibrava. One, two, three, four. Yes! Caught! Woot! And now out comes Swellow, which should be easily taken care of by good old Static. Kecleon! Wait, what am I doing? You know, confuse right. Just cause I can. No. Look, static? Yes. Damn it! Okay, it's more than likely gonna attack static then, since, you know, flying is the weakness of fighting type, which would be Metatite. Lucky for me, it's not very effective on good old static. Now be confused! Thunderbolts! Strong little boy. I'm not a little boy! You and me are probably the same age! In game and in real life. More than likely. Right? Okay. Okay, there's a guy behind there. So, with that, I think we're gonna end this episode here. Next episode of Let's Play Pokemon Colosseum, we'll stop this infernal racket. See you guys then.